Cambridge IGCSE Physics May June 2020 Paper 42 Part 2 Question 6 Part A Figure 6.1 shows an arrangement of glass prisms inside a box. The angles of the prisms are 45 degrees, 45 degrees, and 90 degrees. So the angles are like this. This is a device used to view objects that are behind the wall. The incident ray of light undergoes total internal reflection in the prisms. On figure 6.1, complete the path of the ray through the device and show the ray as it emerges from the box. When you look at the prism here, you'll be able to see something behind this wall because light can travel from the prism above to down here. This is the complete path of the ray. Make sure your lines are straight and heat the prism at 90 degrees. Part B. Show that the refractive index of glass with a critical angle of 45 degrees is 1.41. We have a formula that connects the refractive index and a critical angle. It's n equals to 1 over sine c, n is the refractive index, and c is the critical angle. Since we need to show that if a glass has a critical angle of 45 degrees, its refractive index is 1.41, substitute 45 degrees to this formula. 1 over sine 45 is 1.41, so it's shown. Question 7, Part A. A student makes a transformer that uses an alternating current AC supply with an electromotive force, EMF, of 12 volts to induce an output potential difference, PD, of 2 volts. The student is provided with two lengths of insulated wire and the U-shaped piece of iron shown in Figure 7.1. Complete and label Figure 7.1 to show the transformer connected to the supply and the output from the transformer. We need to make a transformer out of this iron and two lengths of insulated wire, so the primary and secondary coils should be around these two parts of the iron. Now at first, it was supplied with 12 volts and the output is 2 volts, so it's a step-down transformer. Therefore, there should be more coils around the primary coil. Label these and it's done. Explain the function of the piece of iron in the transformer. You'd have noticed that transformers always consist of a piece of iron where coils are wounded. They are to first of all link magnetic fields of coils. They need something to connect the fields and this iron is used. Also, it helps to produce stronger magnetic field in secondary coil because they are closely linked and as a result, there will be better electromagnetic induction. The output of the transformer is connected to a lamp. The current in the lamp is 100 mA. The transformer is 100% efficient. Calculate the input current to the transformer. The output is connected to a lamp, which the current is 100 mA, meaning the current in secondary coil is 100 mA as well. While the power of primary coil is the same as the power of secondary coil, so you can say the product of voltage and current in primary is the same as the product of voltage and current in secondary. We need to find the current of the primary, the input, so I1 is the unknown. Rearrange it, it's I1 equals to V2I2 divided by V1. 100 mA converted to amperes is 0.1 amperes, you need to divide it by 1000. So 2 times 0.1 divided by 12 equals to 0.017 amperes. Part B. Another transformer is used in a school laboratory to step down a main supply with a PD of 110 volts to 12 volts. PD stands for potential difference. This transformer is mounted in a metal case. State and explain an essential safety feature required for this arrangement. It's a metal case which can conduct electricity, so we need to earth it. We need to provide an alternate path for the electricity to flow to the ground or earth in case there is a fault current. So the answer is the metal case needs to be earthed in case the insulation of the wire fails or the live wire touches the case. Live wire means a wire with an active flowing current. Question 8. Part A. A light-emitting diode LED is a diode that emits light when there is a current in it. Draw a circuit diagram showing an LED connected so that it is lit in series with a battery and a fixed resistor. Use standard electrical symbols. You have to know the symbols or an LED, a battery, and a fixed resistor to draw this. These are the symbols. They need to be connected in series, so connect them in one line. It's not hard if you know all the symbols. Part B. The PD across the LED when lit is 3.1 volts and the current in the LED is 0.030 amperes. Calculate the value of the resistance of the LED when lit. This is easy. Resistance equals to voltage divided by current, so 3.1 divided by 0.030, 100 ohms. Part C. Figure 8.1 shows a power supply of EMF 10.5 volts connected in series with a lamp and a heater. The PD across the lamp is 2.1 volts and the current in the lamp is 1.5 amperes. Calculate the resistance of the heater. The current in the series circuit is the same throughout the circuit, so it's also 1.5 amperes. Then for PD, since the power supply was 10.5 volts and the lamp has a PD of 2.1 volts, the PD of the heater is 10.5 minus 2.1, 8.4 volts. Resistance equals to voltage divided by current, so 8.4 divided by 1.5, 5.6 ohms. The power of the heater. Power equals to voltage multiplied by current, so 8.4 times 1.5 equals to 12.6 watts. Question 9. Part A. Complete the truth table shown in table 9.1 for a NAND gate. NAND gate is an opposite of an AND gate, so let's first draw an AND gate. If it was an AND gate, this would have been 0, 0, 0, and 1. So for NAND gate, it would be 1, 1, 1, and 0. Part B. The circuit shown in figure 9.1 contains two different types of gate, labeled X and Y. Table 9.2 shows a partially completed truth table for the circuit. From table 9.2, deduce the name of logic gate Y. Bring your answer from the list. Logic gate has inputs of A and B and produced an output D. So we can consider these two columns as inputs and this column as an output. 00 produced 0, 01 produced 0, 10 produced 0, and 11 produced 1. This is an AND gate. Complete the truth table in table 9.2. We don't know what logic gate X is, so let's first find that out. Inputs are A and B, and the output is C. 00 produced 0, 01 produced 1, 10 produced 1, 11 produced 1. This is an OR gate. So these two are OR gates. Here, C and D are the inputs and E is produced. For an OR gate, 00 is 0, 10 is 1, 10 is 1, 11 is 1. So our final answer is 0, 1, 1, and 1. Part C. There's a current of 3.0 amperes in a copper wire. Calculate how many electrons pass through the copper wire every 60 seconds. The charge on an electron is 1.6 times 10 to the power of negative 19 coulombs. A formula that connects current, time, and charge is Q equals to I times T. Charge equals to current times time. Just substitute the values 3 times 60, 180 coulombs. To find the number of electrons in a charge, we need to divide the charge with charge on one electron given here. So 180 divided by 1.6 times 10 to the power of negative 19 1.1 times 10 to the power of 21. Question 10. Figure 10.1 shows a vacuum tube with a radioactive source. The radioactive source emits alpha particles, beta particles, and gamma rays. There's a very strong magnetic field between the N pole and the S pole of the magnet. Part A. The lead cylinder has a narrow central hole. State and explain the effect of the lead cylinder. Since it has a narrow central hole, the beam will be narrow and emit in a straight line. Also, the radiation in other directions will be absorbed by lead, so you will have a clean emission. Part B. Describe the paths of the alpha particles, beta particles, and gamma rays as they pass through the magnetic field. Explain your answers. Alpha particles. If you use Fleming's left-hand rule, the direction of magnetic field is going down and the current is towards left, so the motion will be out of page towards you. Since alpha particles move in the direction of the current, it will also move out of the page. Beta particles. Beta particles move in the opposite direction of alpha particles in an opposite direction to the beam. From the above question, we found that alpha particles move out of the page, so beta particles will move towards the page. Gamma rays. It will just continue going in a straight line as gamma rays are uncharged and they are not equivalent to current. That's it for this video. Good luck in your exams and leave some comments to support me. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and like if this video helped you. Stay safe and God bless you guys. Bye!